Welcome to Biology at Ease. This video is part 14 of Biological Classification Lecture Series. Pichli video mein humne phylum Ctenophora ke baare mein padha tha. Now in this video I'll be covering two phylums, the phylum Platyhelminthes and the phylum Aschelminthes. To sabse pehle shuru karte hain phylum Platyhelminthes se. In the word Platyhelminthes, the word platy means flat and the word helminths means worms. So Platyhelminthes includes the animals which are commonly known as flat worms. Ab inhe flat worms kyun kaha jata hai? That we will discuss later. Let's first begin with the basic characteristics of the organisms belonging to this phylum. Sabse pehle baat karte hain organization ki. Platyhelminthes mein jitne bhi organisms hote hain, they have organ level of organization, which means in mein tissues combine hoke well developed organs banate hain. So what is the level of organization in Platyhelminthes? The organisms belonging to Platyhelminthes have organ level of organization. Germ layers ki baat karein, to Platyhelminthes are triploblastic in nature. That is, they contains the three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Coelom in mein absent hota hai, therefore they are commonly known as acoelomate organisms. Body form ki baat kare, inki body kaisi hoti hai? So they have long body which is dorso-ventrally flat, aur isi wajah se they are commonly known as flat worms. Dorso-ventrally flat ka matlab kya hota hai? Ki jo aapki flat worms hote hain, inka aap chahe front surface dekho inki body ka, ya fir aap inka back surface dekho, both the surfaces of the body is flat. Yani ki unka front body surface aur back body surface dono flat hota hai. So because of the presence of dorso-ventrally flat body, these organisms are commonly known as flat worms. To body form kaisi ho gayi? The organisms of Platyhelminthes have elongated body and it is dorso-ventrally flat. Symmetry ki baat karein, to they have bilateral symmetry, yani ki a single plane can divide their body into two similar parts. Digestive system in mein incomplete hota hai and there is a only single opening which acts as both mouth and anus. So digestive system is incomplete in case of Platyhelminthes. Habit or habitat ki baat karein, to jo Platyhelminthes ke organisms hote hain, they are mostly parasitic in nature, yani ki wo kisi aur organism pe depend hote hain for obtaining their food. So mostly they are parasitic in nature, serving as endoparasites, yani ki kisi ki body pe completely depend hona for their food. Some may be free living in nature. Kuch organisms hote hain jo ki free living ho sakte hain, which are not dependent on other organisms for their food, and the example includes planaria. To planaria ek aisa Platyhelminth hai, which is free living in nature and it is found in fresh water. And because of this habit and habitat, the planaria is known as freshwater free living Platyhelminth. Reproduction ki baat karein, to jo Platyhelminths hote hain, they are hermaphroditic in nature, which means they are bisexual. In mein male or female reproductive organ single body ke andar hi present hota hai. So the organisms of Platyhelminths are hermaphroditic in nature. Mostly in mein sexual reproduction hota hai, lekin there are some organisms which shows asexual reproduction and the example includes planaria. Planaria kya karta hai? Transfers binary fission, jo ki ek asexual process hai, iske through reproduction karta hai. So reproduction in case of Platyhelminthes is mostly through sexual way, whereas in some organisms asexual reproduction occurs and the example is planaria. In mein excretion flame cells ke through hota hai. So the excretory unit in Platyhelminthes are flame cells which are also known as solenocytes. To ek bar inki characteristics ko dubara se revise kar dete hain. Platyhelminthes is a phylum of dorso-ventrally flat organisms. They have triploblastic germ layers. They are acoelomate. They have organ level of organization, bilateral symmetry. They are hermaphroditic in nature, in which the sexual reproduction is the most common way of reproduction, and the excretory unit is flame cells. अब बात करते हैं Aschelminthes की. जो Aschelminthes phylum है, it is also known as phylum Nemehelminthes. Nemehelminthes में जो word nema होता है, it means thread, and the word helminths means worm. So the organisms belonging to Aschelminthes are commonly known as thread worms. Thread worms क्यों कहा जाता है? क्योंकि इनकी body थ्रेड की तरह थिन और एलोंगेटेड होती है. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ थिन एलोंगेटेड बॉडी सेम एज दैट ऑफ अ थ्रेड, दे आर कॉमनली नोन एज थ्रेड वॉर्म्स. इनमें ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कैसी होती है? दे हैव ऑर्गन सिस्टम लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Platyhelminthes में हमने क्या देखा? Platyhelminthes हैव ऑर्गन लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. लेकिन Aschelminthes के अंदर क्या होता है? द ऑर्गन्स कंबाइन टूगेदर टू फॉर्म अ मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स स्ट्रक्चर विच इज नोन एज ऑर्गन सिस्टम. इनमें जो सीलोम होता है, इट इज नोन एज सीडोसीलोम. सीडोसीलोम का मतलब क्या होता है? नॉर्मली सीलोम क्या होता है? सीलोम इज अ बॉडी कैविटी विच इज मेड अप ऑफ मेसोडर्म. सीलोम एक ऐसी कैविटी है जो कि मेसोडर्म की बनी होती है. इन केस ऑफ Aschelminthes ऑर्गेनिजम्स, ये जो मेसोडर्म है, इट इज प्रेजेंट इन पैचेस. तो कंप्लीट या फिर वेल डेवलप्ड मेसोडर्म प्रेजेंट नहीं होती है. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रीजन Aschelminthes आर सेड टू बी सीडो coelomate. Because of the presence of mesodermal patches in the coelom is known as pseudocoelom, and the organisms, that is the Aschelminthes, are commonly known as pseudocoelomate organisms. Ye question NEET exams mein bahut baar pucha jata hai ki which phylum includes pseudocoelomate organisms. So it is the Nemehelminthes or Aschelminthes phylum. Ab baat karte hain body ki. To Aschelminthes jo phylum hota hai, inke organisms kaise hote hain? They have long cylindrical elongated body. अगर हम symmetry की बात करें तो the symmetry is bilateral symmetry, जिसमें कि single plane divides the organism into two similar parts. इनमें जो digestive system होता है वो complete होता है, which means both mouth and anus are present in case of Aschelminthes. अगर हम इनकी habit की बात करें तो they are mostly parasitic in nature. कुछ organisms होते हैं जो कि free living होते हैं, living in soil and water. उसके बाद बात करते हैं reproduction की. Aschelminthes के जो organisms होते हैं, they are unisexual in nature. इनमें male और female organism separately present होता है, and these organisms shows sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism एक ऐसा phenomenon है जो बताता है कि special characteristic present होती है in both males and females, जिनके basis पे आप male और female को differentiate कर देते हैं. तो Aschelminthes के organisms में क्या होता है? Aschelminthes में जो male organisms होते हैं, जो male worms होते हैं, they are curved. उनकी जो body होती है, वो curved होती है, and their body is shorter as compared to the female worms. So female Aschelminthes have straight and long body as compared to the male worms which have curved body. और इनमें सिर्फ sexual reproduction होता है. So only sexual reproduction occurs in case of Aschelminthes. They are unisexual in nature, showing sexual dimorphism. इनमें जो excretion होता है, it takes place through excretory pore. So in characteristics के basis पे आप Aschelminthes और Platyhelminthes को differentiate कर सकते हैं. सबसे पहले हम include कर सकते हैं organization. Platyhelminthes have organ level of organization, whereas Aschelminthes have organ system level of organization. Platyhelminthes are acoelomate, इनमें coelom absent होती है, whereas Aschelminthes are pseudocoelomate. Digestive system is incomplete in Platyhelminthes, whereas it is complete and well developed in case of Aschelminthes. जो आपका reproduction होता है, Platyhelminthes में both sexual as well as asexual reproduction occurs, whereas in Aschelminthes only sexual reproduction occurs. And the organisms of Aschelminthes phylum are unisexual in nature, जबकि जो phylum Platyhelminthes है, they are hermaphroditic in nature, they are bisexual in nature. Excretion की बात करें, तो Aschelminthes में excretory pore के through excretion होता है, whereas in case of Platyhelminthes organisms, the excretion takes place through flame cells, which are also known as solenocytes. ये basic characteristics थी जिनके basis पे आप इन दोनों phylums को differentiate कर सकते हैं. Now let's have a look upon some additional points जिनको आप इन phylums के अंडर include कर सकते हैं. Fertilization की बात करें तो Platyhelminthes के जो organisms होते हैं, they shows internal fertilization, यानी कि इनमें fusion of male and female gamete occurs inside the body of the female organisms. और Aschelminthes में भी internal fertilization present होता है. Development in both Aschelminthes as well as in Platyhelminthes takes place either through direct development or through indirect ways. यानी कि इनमें कुछ organisms होते हैं which shows direct development, जिनमें larval stage form नहीं होती है. Embryo direct baby organism में form हो जाता है. लेकिन there are some organisms in which larval stage is present. So in both Aschelminthes as well as Platyhelminthes, both direct or indirect development takes place. In some organisms, direct development occurs, whereas in some other organisms, larval stage is involved in the life cycle, and that is why we say that they have indirect development. Common name की बात करें तो Platyhelminthes are commonly known as flatworms because of their dorso-ventrally flat body. और Aschelminthes का common name होता है threadworm because of their cylindrical elongated body. और उन्हें roundworm भी कहा जाता है क्योंकि अगर आप इन Aschelminthes का transverse cross section देखें, अगर आप इनको बीच से cut करें और ये वाला region देखें, so you will find circular pattern. And because of this round or circular pattern, pattern, the Aschelminthes are commonly known as roundworm. तो common name क्या हो गया? Platyhelminthes का common name हो गया है flatworm and the Aschelminthes are commonly known as roundworm or threadworm. Examples की बात करें तो Platyhelminthes include Stenia solium, which is commonly known as pork tapeworm, Fasciola, which is known as liver fluke, Dugesia, which is known as planaria, Tenia saginata, which is known as beef tapeworm. अगर हम Aschelminthes के examples की बात करें तो Aschelminthes includes Ascaris, which is commonly known as roundworm, Ancylostoma, which is known as hookworm, and Enterobius, which is also known as pinworm. So these are the basic characteristics of the phylum Platyhelminthes and the phylum Aschelminthes. I hope you're clear with the content. If you like this video, do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching.